Hi class 6, welcome back to the maths class once again. So what we are going to learn today, we are going to learn some of the rules of divisibility. Now what is the reason or what is the need of knowing all this kind of rules or anything? So for that I'll say that say I have given you a big number, then you are given any kind of number and say divide this number. Now how will you understand that by which number you are going to divide that big number? For that you have to know that some rules or some of the shortcut methods, and this divisibility method is going to give you such kind of shortcut methods how you are going to do this kind of division bigger with the bigger numbers in a less time and easier way. Okay, so first of all, how you are going to understand that whether a number is going to be divided by 2 or not. Okay, for that what we have to understand, see here I have taken 2 numbers. For example, we have to see the last numbers. Okay, see for 372 the last number is 2 and for 120 the last number is 0. Okay, now we have to see whether the last number is divided by 2 or not. Okay, so 2 is divided by 2 is divided by 2 gives 1, 0 once again is divided by 2 gives 0. So here we can say yes, both of the numbers they are divided by 2 itself. So you can do it by your own and see whether they are dividing by 2 or not. I'm sure they will be divided. Okay, now coming to the number second type of divisibility, that is by 3. Okay, now how we are going to understand this? For that, another type of rules we are going to follow, that we will add all of the digits of a number. So here 132, so how we are going to do? 1 plus 3 plus 2. Okay, so after that we have to see what number is coming. So here 6 is coming, then we have to see this summation is getting divided by 3 or not. Okay, so here 6 is divided by 3 gives 2, so yes, then this number will be divided by 3 itself. Okay, so how we can see summation of the digits will be divided by 3 or not. Okay, coming to the number 4. This is pretty similar to the rules we use for number 2 or divisibility by 2. Here for 4 we are going to see last 2 numbers. Okay, so here 36, see 36 is divided by 2 or not. So sorry, not 2, it's 4. So 4 5s are 20, 4 6s are 24, 4 9s are 36. Okay, so we have to see last two digits divided by 4 or not. Okay, so as this number, last two numbers or last two digits are divided by 4 itself to give 9, we can say that whole number will be divided by 4 itself. Okay, now coming to the number 5, this is pretty simple and easy. I hope many of you know also. We have to see the last two numbers. If both of the numbers or any of this number belong to 0 or 5, okay, then we can understand this number will be divided by 5 itself. So here, if the last digit be 0 or 5, then the number is divided by 5 itself. Okay, coming to the last one, that is divisibility by 6. How we are going to understand this? Now here we have to add this for the first number I have taken. Let's see how this goes. 5 plus 3 plus 0 plus 2 plus 2. Now, this is pretty similar to the divisibility by 3 roots. Okay. So, what is the addition of this or summation of this 3, all these numbers? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now, here, number 12 has been coming as the summation of this number. Now, you have to see whether this summation is divided by both 2 or and 3. Okay. So, here, if we are dividing 12 by 2, it gives 6. Once again, if it is divided by 3, it gives 4. So, yes, we can understand from here that this number is divided by 6 itself. Because why by 2 and 3 both? Because these two are the factors of 6. Right? 2 into 3 gives 6. So, the summation should be divided by both of the 2 and 3. Okay. Not by either 2 or 3. So, here how can we say that summation or sum of the digits should be divided by 2 and 3 itself. Okay. If it is divided, then whole of the number is divided by 6 itself. Okay. So, this is how we do the divisibility by 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And for the rest of the numbers like 7 to 10 and 11, we are going to know in our next class. So, this is it for this class. And we are going to learn the rest of it in our next class. So, thank you.